right, the project at hand right now is I want to make an excavator bucket from scratch. So the bucket we've been making, I want to make it like a trenching bucket that with like a V shape to it for doing drainage swales. So I brought the machine in here and a normal bucket just to kind of look at it. The only thing I did buy was a set of these quick coupler ears. The reason being is these have to be cut out very accurately, and it's without a water jet table, it's just kind of easier to buy that. Let's see how these lock in here. So you go in like that, and then the pin goes across. Seven sixteenths thick where there's no diamonds, 32 wide. Center. These are supposed to be 8 3/4. So it should be 4 3/8. So the insides. Oh, these diamonds up. So this took a little bit, but I think I got these perfect. They do sell these with ready welded on here, which is kind of almost worth it because it's because these got to be right. Like every direction has to be perfect. Welding something like this, so you wouldn't want to go do a full weld on one side, because what would happen is the weld shrinks when it cools and it would bend this a lot. So you got to do a little bit here and there. All right, this is gonna be the bottom of the bucket. And this is 1/2 inch. that's what's gonna be digging into the ground, so at least that's cut square now. I just wanted a little bit of an angle for cutting. So there's the bottom of the bucket. Piece is coming up like that. So let's figure out an angle. Right there is 45. I'm thinking more in the neighborhood of there. Made the top plate 32 inches wide. So 16. That would only give us a 12 inch tall bucket. That's not really enough. I don't want to just come up square. I want to be like this. So this needs to be cut at like that. Well, that looks pretty good. My side plates. This is hardened steel. And there's that. So you go right there. Getting the angle of this right is important, because if it's like flat, what happens is the machine, it won't curl enough, and like you go to load a truck and it'll just be spilling out of the bucket if you lift it high up in the air. You go to this bucket, what we got? 20. Let's see, we got 25 in there. So let's just do that the same. So we got 10. So I could have gone straight across here, but I want to increase the capacity, so doing this. What you doing? What are you doing, buddy? What are you doing? You're not supposed to jump on people. You're not supposed to be doing this. It's okay. It's okay. Woo, woo, woo. We gotta make a bucket. We're making a bucket right now, buddy. We're gonna make a bucket. We can just cut this across right here. Or to there. It's like this should go. Obviously, that needs a plate like this. But how far up? Then what? Like. This one right here. There's that angle. Okay. make sure. Two feet exactly. There we go. It's all coming together. Do this so. Right there. Okay, that's gotta be 10 1/4 long. Just trying to figure out where to see there. That's easy to fill. I'm gonna make the call right now and say this is gonna get cut to here. I'm explaining my thought process. That's there. Oh yeah, see now I just got two more triangles. Two. This is extra metal for my roof. That's nice. This plate work here should. Oh yeah. Come on. welder was doing the job, but you know what? This thing's got more power. I'd rather finish welding it with that. That was a good excuse to get it off the roof too, since I'm done up there. All right, one more piece this needs is the reinforcement on this. Since this is so long, this would probably bend right here. Maybe, I don't know, it's a pretty thick plate I got on here, but you can see what they did on this bucket here. You know, we got about 2 inches at least coming down. And then it curves back into it. So if I just cut this, cut that like that. Today's December 31st, the last thing I did for the year, make this bucket. Well, that's all done, let's put it on the machine and paint it. So here's a look at it out in the daylight. It looks nice. I like it. Yeah, let's give that thing a try. So we're down in my lower field here, and I just kind of want to clean up the entrance into this pond a little better, just like to, you know, so there's not like puddles like this. I don't want to go deep though. Like that bucket can go much. I just want to go a few inches. But let's start. See, I had dug this. But see if we can dig this nicer. Oh, that's nice. Thank you. right, so that worked pretty good. I mean, I still want to be able to drive a lawnmower through this ditch, so I wanted it not very deep, but even just having that makes like an air like that so much drier. That was fun. Let's go find another ditch to jig. I was torn on what angle to make it too. It's like, I mean, I almost feel like it could have been flatter too, but then at the same time, like, you know, how flat do you make it? I mean, these ditches like this tend to fill in over time anyway, so, but, you know, I think a lawnmower could get through that no problem. I'm gonna try just cleaning out this ditch right here. There is a pipe about here that goes across. It's mostly cleaning leaves, but let's just see how it does.
Thank you.
All right, so that worked pretty good. I started doing this. I was like, oh, let me just clean the leaves out of this trench because it's been working fine. But then I was having so much fun digging. I kind of widened up stuff. And it rained a ton last night, too. That's why everything's so wet. But nice here. I was able to move the trench over to the left a little bit. And it's nice hammering too, because then when you're hammering rock, you get driveway rock, so. Alright, one more thing I want to do here. I want to just do a very shallow trench to dry up this puddle. Hey buddy, what do you got there? What do you got? Show me what you got. Alright, that's working. This spot needs a drop of gravel, but... Alright, here's that spot an hour later. It's dried up. Alright, Levi, are you ready to check on everything? It involves water, so you're an expert at that. Alright, so, calling that project a success. This bucket definitely works good. I mean, it does what I expected it to, you know, digging triangle-shaped drainage swales. So yeah, that was a pretty easy project. That pretty much took 2 short days, and I didn't buy anything to do this except for these ears. So I mean, and the reason I made this bucket, because I couldn't really find anyone selling them like this, so it just kind of made sense to make it. All right, here's this trench here the next day. It did rain really hard last night, so, but you can see. All right, well, we're all set. Let's go work on something else. What do you think, buddy? What do you think? Hey, Cody, you swimming?